Okay, good afternoon. Good morning again. So this is our first day class, October 8, 2020, pandemic period virtual class. I gave all the information. Okay, we're gonna start our formal IC3. Let me start by okay, with our first lesson. Okay, the objectives of today's lessons are the following. We differentiate between apps and applications. We identify various types of application software and the tasks for which they are suited. The video shifting or the slide shifting is slow, right? Okay, I will wait for maybe 2-3 seconds before I talk. Understand and use web apps. I'm already on the third bullet. Use an app store to browse and find apps. Install, delete, and recover apps. Describe the strengths and weaknesses of apps and applications. Next slide. Okay, so next slide is all about apps and application. What is the difference? So actually they are really the same. So let's just go directly here. I'll read it first so I can discuss this both all together. Both together. Applications are complex programs designed to be used with a mouse and keyboard. Apps are small and lightweight. They are designed to be used on touchscreen devices. So the lesson is giving us an idea that when we call it apps, it's used for the touchscreen devices, mobile phones, smartphones, your iPad, your tabs. Okay, so those are called apps. Okay, but you know also that there are laptops, big or wide screens laptops that are touch screens. Okay, so nowadays, yes, they are correct in definition because in smartphones, we call it apps. We don't call it applications, really. But this is just a play of words in maybe 10 years ago, okay, when all this web development, application, smartphone app development was going on, or maybe 15 years ago. Of course, it's really called application. And then, of course, when they started this development of different apps, so they just shortened it up. So, but it's the same, okay? Whatever you're doing on a computer, you're going to do on a device. The difference is that on a mobile device or a smartphone or a tab, it's a touch screen, okay? Another difference is that, of course, a desktop has bigger capacity or higher, what do you call it? Yes, bigger capacity. Bigger hard drives. RAM is bigger, the video also, the video graphics RAM, or those internal device that is in charge of your screens are bigger on a laptop or a desktop. Okay, so what I'm saying is that, of course, on a laptop or a desktop, you have to make, you can create or design an application, a software, or you can program anything that is, I mean, capable of those, or that can be stored or that can run on those devices, desktop and laptops. While when you're having a smartphone, you have a smaller capacity. That means you have to have the program to be lighter. When you say lighter, not doesn't need a big hard disk or hard drive, or meaning the storage capacity is small, or I mean needs small amount or something like this. This is what why what's the difference, and it's really similar, it's really the same. Okay, it's just a play of words, I'm telling you. Okay, but nowadays they made it formal, as you say, as you can see, it's on our IC3 GS5. GS5 is Global Standard 5, because IC3 evolved from different standards. Okay, so right now actually the Global Standard 6 is available, and you are lucky because we are in Global Standard 5. That means it's still not new. We have still resources for the IC3, and that's what we're doing right now. Because if you are the first batch to do the next standard or the newest standard, for most of the time it's really difficult, because we are all trying to adapt. Anyway, let's proceed. So I was saying the standard is already written that you call for a touchscreen mobile device, smartphone, iPad apps, and then for laptops and desktop applications. But they are all programs, okay? And this software, they are both software, by the way, we are talking about software. They are both doing a particular task, okay? A function, okay? You do not have application or apps if it's just going to be there on your mobile phone. If that's there, you download it and you're not going to use it, remove it, okay? So one tip for your phone, because most of the time there are users that just download apps, okay? And then you can see your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 have 10 screens with different apps. What's this? That's ridiculous for me. Okay, so you are a person, you are a human being, you will not use all of those apps, so remove it if you're not using it. If you will need it, download and install. Okay, and then you found that 1 month you're not using that app, remove, kalas. Okay, why? To reserve resources on your phone. Okay, so even though these are not topics of IC3, or maybe it will be a topic later on in some other parts, but those are the tips that I'm giving you. Okay, let's proceed. An application program. 1, 2, 3. Okay. Different types of programs are suited to different types of tasks. So when we say application programs, we are generalizing already. It's either apps on mobile phone or applications on a desktop or laptop. But this is our software, application programs, application software, or software. Although there are two types of software, this is the application software. Okay, we're talking about application software. The other type of software, I'm sure you're familiar, the operating system or the system software. So those are the ones that is running your computer, your Windows, your Mac, the iOS. What else? Windows, Linux. Okay, for some computer, for devices, it's either iOS and there's also a Windows for mobile and Android. Okay. It is important to select the appropriate software program for the task at hand. So you have to be familiar about the task first. What do I need to do? And then you select the software that you need. Okay. Sometimes there are software that's very complicated or very, so let's say, sophisticated. I mean, it's expensive. So do you need that? So that's the question that you have to ask. Like, for example, Adobe Photoshop. You need to buy it. You need to buy the license if you really need it. For most of those who have a hobby of photography, then they need Adobe Photoshop, because if your hobby is photography and you're just editing through the software that comes through your with your phone or with your camera also, or maybe you will use a web or you go online to edit those pictures and photos, then you're limiting your hobby on photography. Anyway, let's proceed. Okay, many programs share a number of features. Look closely at what you want to accomplish. Word processing, of course, Microsoft Word is an example. Aside from typing and, you know, doing a letter or maybe doing a 1,000-word essay, Word can also do this. Memos, invoices, faxes, articles, and sometimes basic web pages, newsletters, forms, brochures, or flyers. So as I said earlier, you choose the software according to the task. Suppose, for example, I want to do a brochure. If my brochure is very simple and it's not for commercial, or it's not like I am in a company where I need to really do an advertisement, something like this, or I'm not the one going to do the brochure for Geotech. I'm just going to do a brochure for my students, for example, a simple brochure. Then I will just use Microsoft Word. Okay, I will not require anything else. There are other programs that can do these brochures, newsletters, books, magazines, okay, which is sophisticated. When I say sophisticated, advanced in features. Those are the desktop publishing. Okay, it manipulates large amounts of text and graphics and requires specialized page layout or structure. So you have Microsoft Publisher. Sorry, can I ask, is the shifting of the pages or the slides, am I on sync, in sync with the pages? Anybody can answer, no problem.
It is, you are.
Yeah, it
you
is.
Are. Yeah, it is.
Okay, because in my other here, it took 4 or 5 seconds before it shifted. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, so desktop publishing, example is Microsoft Publisher. And then we have Adobe InDesign. Those are the softwares that are used for publishers. So those are for advanced, as I said. So you choose what suited your requirement or what that you need, the software that you need before you have it. For example, you're just doing some small, as I said, flyers, for example. You are on a band and then you want to have a small concert in your community. Maybe I'm not making sense. Okay. You have a gig, you are a DJ, you want to have some advertisement. So you can use Microsoft Word on that. It's very small layout, pictures, then fonts, and so on and so forth. You can do it there. Okay. But if you're talking about a concert of, let's say, audience of 5,000 to 10,000, then you will not choose Microsoft Word. That's very, very, what they call this? It will be out of style or something. Okay, so you have to use the different desktop publishing software. If you are an architect, you are in that profession of advertising, most likely you're going to use different publishing softwares. Okay, spreadsheets. Excel, I'm not going to explain it anymore. What can you do? It has table, it has rows and columns, it has cell. So what can you do there? You put data, okay, and then after that, you can manipulate, you can analyze, you can have graphs, you can have numbers to have formulas, okay, compute and so on and so forth. That's what's the use of this Excel. Okay, and then just for your information, in the bachelor, I'm teaching the advanced Excel. So for those who will go for the first year, first semester, next year, or next academic year, I'm not sure because sometimes the advanced Excel is not offered on that semester. If you have German courses, I think that's already your life skills course. And once you reach the level that you don't have German course anymore, or if German courses is not offered, then you can select advanced Excel. So I'm the one teaching that. Maybe one of or in the future you will be my student there. But let me go back. Application, the spreadsheet is really the advanced the Excel, Microsoft Excel as a software is very, very useful. It's one of the useful. I think even more than the Word, Microsoft Word, I'm using this a lot, Microsoft Excel. Okay, graphic design and image editing, Photoshop, of course, but if you have just need to rotate or, save as JPEG or change the file type, you can use Microsoft Paint. There are a lot of graphic design and image editing and even web-based, which is you go to the website of these things and you can edit. But most of the time, mostly use is Adobe Photoshop. Okay, web development. For computer scientists, maybe you will encounter how to or you will experience how to develop a web page, and the software program that's called for this is Hypertext Markup Language, HTML. I'm not sure if you're seeing this HTML page, that HTML. So this is the program, okay? But there are programs that are, web development programs that is very easy. Just click and drag and just small coding, you can have a web page. But for more advanced or more functional web page, when you say functional or dynamic, it has some interaction and linkages and so on, you will still need to write the program in HTML. Okay, but it's very easy. Don't be intimidated. Even if you're not a computer scientist, if you try to learn this, maybe in one day, you're gonna learn how to do a web page. Okay, video editing software, manipulate video images, stream segments, resequence clips, add transitions, special effects, and captions. A lot of you maybe are very familiar of video editing. There are a lot of softwares also out there, even in your phone. You have some photos, videos, you can edit it through your phone, okay? And then later on upload it. So for professionals, video editors are Adobe Premiere one, of course. What else? Okay, I don't have anything in my mind right now. So for video editing, for me Adobe, since Photoshop it's related to Premiere, and there even Photoshop you can have a basic video editing also. If you will also take that in your bachelor as a life skills course, the Photoshop, you will learn that also. What else? On your desktop, on your Windows 10, for example, you have photos, okay? So the application is called Photos, so just open that and you can edit videos there, okay? So just 2 seconds, I'll just drink water. Okay, I'm back. Presentation PowerPoint. Simple as that. I will not talk anymore about this. You know this. Okay. So what is a web app? A web app, of course, or web apps. What are web apps? It runs on the World Wide Web. Okay, do not run directly on a device. That means if you have a device, for example, you find the link or the icon that will open that app, that is what we call local applications. But here, when you say web application, this is run through web. What do you need? You need a Google Chrome, a web browser. Okay, Safari, Google Chrome, Firefox, whatever. You open that and you go to the site and then log in. Okay, it is platform independent. So that means either you use iOS, you use a Android, you use Windows. When you say this app, you have to go to their browser. Of course, if you're using iOS, you have to use Safari. If you're using Google Chrome, you have to use Google Chrome. If you're using a MacBook or anything, okay? So we're talking about web browser. So your web browser, of course, there are limitations. So like for example, there are applications that doesn't run on this web browser. So that's given. We cannot get away from that. Although we're saying it's platform independent. Okay, platform is your operating system. Okay, store our files in the cloud. Our access through cloud account. So you have to have an account. An example is your Office 365, your Google account. Okay, those are the example of web applications. Okay, Google Docs, Google Sheets, Google Slides. Now, when you go to office.com, it's the same. You have OneDrive, you have Outlook there, your Microsoft Teams web-based is also there. Even the Word, Excel, PowerPoint, you can access through there. Okay? Now, since we're talking about the office.com already, by the way, for those who still doesn't know, you can have your license for your Microsoft Offices, Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Access, whatever is available there. Even Microsoft Teams, you can use your Outlook. You can download those applications on your laptop or your desktop, and then you can activate it using your Geotech email. That is because you are part of our organization. So it's paid already by Geotech. It's already covered in your registration. Okay, so local apps, I just said local apps are installed and run directly to a device, are operating system specific. So of course, when you download, for example, any software, even if it is free, you will need to check, this is for Windows, this is for Mac, okay, so, or yes, Mac OS. And so on and so forth. Okay, most people use apps on tablets and smartphones. Okay, local applications, of course, we're talking about desktop earlier. Now also, it can be applicable to apps and on tablets. Mobile devices include pre-installed apps and an app that takes you to the App Store. Okay, so of course, smartphones always have an App Store. By the way, App Store now is a generic term that we're talking, we're referring to all the stores where you can get your apps, okay, in mobile devices, okay? Doesn't say, I'm not saying that, oh, they were talking only about iOS, okay? But different app stores, so you can see that it's generic, but of course, when you say the platform, iOS is called App Store. When you say Android, we call it Play Store. Is it still Play Store? I'm not familiar anymore of Android. Windows Store.
It is still the Play Store.
Google Play Store. Okay. But for Android, anyway, it's your phone. You're mostly familiar. Thank you very much. And then BlackBerry. BlackBerry World. Wow. How many of you knows BlackBerry or have seen BlackBerry? Mohammed, yes, very good. Esa, Isra, Ayub, Amna. How old are you when you saw this kind of phone? Give me an age. Maybe 7 years old from your father. Okay, because you know, when the messaging is actually the history of BlackBerry, it boomed or it was famous when messaging started. When you say messaging, it's the use of the mobile phone or the internet. Just give me a minute. I need to take this call. Huh? Okay, started during the messaging period wherein you use your data, not data, but you are connected, for example, to Omantel, and then you can have a BlackBerry to BlackBerry messaging. So that's how it started before. Okay, they are very famous mobile phone. So anyway, it goes, I mean, of course, you know the rest of the story. iPhone came. So when iPhone came, using of the smartphone is very, very popular or became popular that time. And, you know, of course, after iPhone, then Android also came and so on and so forth. So the rest is this story. So BlackBerry became didn't able to compete the market. So it closed. When did it close? I think 2 years ago or 3 years ago. I forgot already. But because I remember this, that BlackBerry, I was teaching IT also. Yeah, I think also in GS5. So it must be 2 or 3 years ago. So they closed down, and I told my student they closed that because I was discussing this. Okay, anyway, let's proceed. Okay, browsing an app store. So you have to go to the app store. Okay. I will not discuss this because I think you know already. You go to the app store and then go to the text box, search for the apps, and then click get or install, what, open or what, whatever. Okay, so if it is already installed in your mobile phone, it will say open if it is not yet there on your mobile phone or your smartphone. It will say get. Of course, there are different types of applications, okay, on with different purpose or apps. We will call this apps. The first one is the productivity or communication apps. Okay, productivity apps are programs that allow you to get work done. You can use them to create documents and other files or to communicate with others. Okay, so the amount of work you're doing on the time, you're going to use productivity or communication apps. And communication apps, of course. So we have, of course, Microsoft Word. I'm not sure what is this. This is Cribbon. Skype. Not familiar. Hangout. I think Google Hangout. Okay, content apps. Aggregate news and information mostly. Maybe some of you or you're still in that generation that you don't care about this. Maybe some. I will not generalize. Yes, there are somebody on in your age that cares about news already. So for us, me, I don't use. I just go to YouTube, okay, mostly for news and information. Most of the news channels have their YouTube channel, so I'll just go there. Creativity apps, drawings and so on. Social media apps, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and so on and so forth. There are a lot of social media apps. And I think when 5 years ago, it was Snapchat who boomed here, or which boomed here, you know, man. But what I know is a lot of your age or generation are using Instagram. A lot, I'm not saying all, but a lot of yeah, Omani's famous here is Instagram and WhatsApp. In the Philippines, it's Facebook that is very famous. We're one of the high users. Zainab, you have a question, sorry, because your hand is still raised.
Okay. No, I just forgot.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, audio apps. Not familiar, iTunes, I think, and Spotify only. The others, I'm not sure. Can stream or just play audio content on your phone or from your mobile device. Yes, of course, the video streaming applications. YouTube, Udemy, I'm not sure if you're familiar, Hulu. But of course, this is the Hulu and the others are, yes, watch ESPN, watch. They're targeting the US market. But Netflix is the one which boomed this pandemic period. Okay, HBO from the US also tried to enter globally. Yeah, but I think Netflix was outstanding. I think because it's cheaper than the HBO. But anyway, of course, for me, I'm only using YouTube and Netflix. That's it. Okay, searching the in-app, in the App Store. Searching the App Store. So I told you already, you go to the App Store, Google Store, whatever, Play Store. Type the application that you're looking for and you will see it. Okay, you will see also if it is free or not. If not, you need to do an in-app purchasing. Okay, for now, as I said, you download and then install and so on. So find the app, open the detail page, click install. Okay, so you're now seeing some of the slides, which is like a bullet type, and it's like step by step what to do. Find the app, open the detail page, click install. So there are questions in the exam that will look like this. Okay, so even like in this column, these steps are written, and then in this column, you're going to arrange it. Okay, so you're going to click the first step, then the second step, then the third step, and so on. So I'm already giving you some tips and ideas on how the exam will be. So there are questions like, how do you obtain an app, okay, on your mobile phone? So, or another way of, of course, it might change the wordings. Obtain means, how do you get? How do you, how do you have an application, or how do you install? And okay, obtain is just another word for getting. Okay, so that's another, I mean, another tip of this will be rewarded during the exam. And then in-app purchases, of course, if it is not free, as I've shown you, you have to do an in-app purchases. Purchases made from within a mobile app, entire purchasing process is completed from within the application. Okay, so process can be automatic if payment information is up to date. You can configure your device to ask for a password when making in-app purchases. Okay, so for example, normally what will Apple ask you is to have an iCloud or an account. Okay, so an account from them. I think in Android that's not really that a big issue, but if you're an iPhone user, that one is an issue. They will ask you mostly in applications about the account in iCloud and so on and so forth. Okay, so when you do the purchases, it's linked there and so on. Okay, so some of the purchases, you really have to provide that information. For me right now, I'm not that into purchases using my mobile phone. I usually use free applications and so on. If it has a payment, I will not go for it. Let's proceed. Oh, I finished. I think that's the last one. Okay. No. I think two more slides. Sorry. Okay, to delete an app on Android, to uninstall an app on iPhone or iPad. So these are just two. Why do you need to install or uninstall, so delete or uninstall an application? So of course, if it is not working properly. Okay, so in Android, you can see the different steps. Open the Google Play Store app, touch the menu icon, then tap My Apps and Games. Now, I'm not sure anymore if this is true. I'm not updated because this is Android, so I'm just... Anyway, the whole idea is to uninstall or remove the application from your mobile phone. Why? Because it's not working anymore. So you have to remove it or not working properly and then install again. Okay, so this is why it's being taught here. Now, to uninstall an app on an iPhone, go to home screen, the icon for the app to delete, press and hold the icon. So once you press and hold, it will giggle and you can click the X to remove. Yes, Mohammed.
On Android, it's the same as iPhone.
So you just hold the app.
Yeah, the app and X.
Okay, so I think this is outdated anymore. Yes, so thank you very much for that. Okay, so let's proceed. Okay, recover an app on Android. Again, I'm not sure if this is true still. Open the Play Store, click the menu button, tap My Apps and Games, tap the All tab, tap the app you want to recover, then click Install. So I don't think this is true anymore. You just go to Play Store, type the application, and again, just install. Don't need to go to this one and so on. I think it's the same in iOS. If you remove it, go again to App Store, find it. So the difference is it will not show get. It will just show, I'm not sure what's the word. Is it install? No. Or open? Anyway, so I think you're getting the idea. You just go to the stores. Okay, So lesson summary, I think this is all also our objectives. We covered it, so there's no issue. Now let's have some questions here, and I want you to raise your hand to answer the question one by one. I will call your name, whoever comes or raise his hand first. Go. First question. Raise your hand. Which type of program is designed to be used on touchscreen devices such as tablet? Amnal Balushi.
Apps.
Letter B, apps. Thank you very much. Lower your hands now. Number two. What is a productivity program dedicated to? Yes, Tariq. Tariq Al-Shidhani, yes. What's the answer to number two? No, Tariq? Isra.
See?
Just give me a minute. Huh? Is it recording the amount of time you spend online?
Yes.
Okay, I'm verifying the answer to that. I'm trying to find the answer. Just give me a minute. Where's that? I'll stop sharing first, huh? Where was the answer to this? It's not here. Where was that? Yes, I have a doubt. Okay, here. Okay, there are two answers to the questions. I will show it to you again. Yes. Who was that earlier? There are two answers to the questions, to this question. Yes, Bayan.
Is it A, producing information?
There are two answers to the question. So, producing information and?
See, recording the amount of time you spend online.
Recording the amount of time you spend online. Why will you do that? Why will you do the recording of time you spend online? Okay, anyway. Productivity program is dedicated to Bayan. That's not the correct answer. The first one is correct, producing information. That's why you saw in that application. Isra, can you help?
I think it's B.
Okay, keeping track of files and folders and producing information. So A and B is the correct answer. The explanation, a productivity program is one that is dedicated to producing information such as documents, presentations, worksheets, database, charts, graphs, digital images, websites, electronic music, or digital video. So let's go back to that presentation so that we can understand more. Oops. Okay, so here is the slide. Productivity or communication apps. Productivity apps are programs that allow you to get the work done. You can use them to create documents and other files or to communicate with others. So communication apps here, I mean productivity is explained here. Okay, programs that allow you to get the work done. So in our question, what is a productivity program dedicated to producing information and keeping track of files and folders? So I think you can also apply the process of elimination when we're trying to answer multiple choice questions. So recording the amount of time you spend online, because the idea of productivity program is you produce something, so even if it will take you a long time, so I think it doesn't matter if you how much time you spend. Tracking items you search for, again, this is not the issue with productivity program. So these are softwares that help you produce something. Okay, so keeping track of files and folders is also a part of this, because all the things that you're producing, as I said earlier, such documents, presentations, worksheets, databases, charts, graphs, and so on. Okay, so you have to store it in a file or folder. Okay. Number three. Let's proceed. What do some users refer to web apps as? Web applications, softwares, Ragad Algailani?
Is it software as a service?
Yes, software as a service, SaaS. Okay, SaaS, software as a service, web application. What are the needed things before you can have web as a service? One, an email account, okay? Because to go for applications like that, you need an email account, you have to log in, okay? Of course, it will require you to have a username and password later on, okay? So example, Office 365, your office.com, you have to sign in and then use your Geotech account. Okay, number four, which term properly describes a web app that will run in a browser on any computing device, regardless of the operating system? Number four, Isa Al-Busaidi?
Cloud-based?
We're talking about term that properly describes an app that will run in a browser or any computing device regardless of the operating system.
Compatible then?
It's letter. Bayan, do you want to help?
B. Platform independent.
It's platform independent. So when you say platform, on most of the time in IT, we call that platform is your operating system. Okay, when you say platform, iOS, Android, it doesn't matter. Okay, so as I said earlier. Okay, let's proceed. What is a digital platform for distributing software called? Zainab.
App Store.
Sorry, App Store. Yes, thank you very much. And then number six. What do you need to have before you can use the Facebook app? Tarek? Tarek Ashidani? Yes, Tarek Ashidani, Tarek?
Yes, can you hear me?
Yes, now I can hear you,
okay.
Sir.
Facebook account.
Okay, very good, of course. What do you need to have before you can use the Facebook app? So he's, or the question is referring to before you can use the Facebook app already. Like when you open, of course, you have to log in and so on and so forth. But, okay, I think also we have to be familiar that any kind of app, the first thing that you have to use to have is an email, okay, an email, personal email, whatever email, because you have to register on that application or social media, whatever, and then you can use the app, the mostly the social media app or the web-based app, as I said earlier. Okay, let's proceed. Which of the following is an example of productivity or communication app? You showed this earlier.
So the slide didn't change.
Okay. Let's wait. Let me unshare and share it again. That's number seven. Which of the following is an example of a productivity or a communication app? Yes, Isa?
Skype.
Skype, yes, that's one. Thank you. Elimination. Twitter is a social media. iTunes is what do you call this? Audio streaming. And then CNN is a content app. Okay, number eight. What kind of app group news of information presenting them on a device when you launch the app? Group news. Tarek? No? Okay. Nobody? Group news and information. Bayan?
Content.
Content. Thank you very much. Number nine, what type of app is the smart tool app? Smart tools app. Tarek?
Creativity.
Yes, creativity app. Okay, so it was there in... Okay, check if my slides is changing. Okay, creativity apps are those that allow you to be creative or to use tools in a creative manner. I think it's this one. I'm not sure which, if it is available on your... different applications. I'm not really sure. Okay. Okay. 10. Okay. Which program best represents what you can do on a social media or social networking site? Mariam, all my money.
Instagram?
Yes, Instagram. Thank you very much. What is it called when your device, receives a constant flow of data from a source location and then plays the file instantly? So you have a file location away from you, and then you're playing it at the same time. Mohammed? Al-Kindi?
Streaming.
Yes, yeah, streaming. Okay, so there are terms here, technical terms, downloading, uploading, flowing, and streaming. Flowing is not really a term in IT. Right now, uploading and downloading, I think you know, you upload, you save the file going to a server or to another computer. You download, you get that file from that server or that computer to your computer. So even if it is a video, you say downloading, you're not playing it. You're getting the file first. Once you have your file there, and then you can now play. So that's not streaming. Okay, streaming is you're playing it at the same time that you're downloading those files or you're getting those files. Which of the following apps can stream video to your device? Ayub Al-Kindi.
Hello.
Ayub. Yes, sir. You, sorry?
Yes.
Yes, sir. What's the answer?
Hulu.
Hulu. Okay. So, yes, I think that's correct. Okay, but I think Facebook can do the streaming also, but, you know, it's not dedicated for that. Hulu is the one. Okay, some more questions? For 13, which option should you use when you want to obtain an app?